What's up, everybody? This is Tina, aka B from San Diego, in the kitchen today. Today we're going to be cooking a few things. The first thing that we're going to cook is oxtails. See the oxtails? Nice. These things are really good. You may not like them or you may have never tried them, but if you have tried them and you like beef, I'm sure you'll like them. Okay, I've already washed the oxtails. Now what we're going to do is season them up well. First thing we're going to season them with is some garlic powder. Not garlic salt, just garlic powder. Season them generously. My hands are washed. I've already washed my hands. Okay, next we're going to use some onion powder. I always use onion powder in my cooking. Season them up generously. Now I'm going to use some Pappy's seasoning. This is like an all-purpose seasoning, mainly used for meat. Okay, they're seasoned up pretty generously. Now I'm going to use some Worcestershire sauce. Worcestershire, however you pronounce it. Just sprinkling it all over. This gives beef flavor, meat, and even chicken and poultry just a good flavor, good taste. Okay. Now I'm going to use some soy sauce. This soy sauce I got from an Asian market near my home, and it is reduced sodium. The sodium is only 310 per tablespoon, so you know it's still salty, but not nearly as salty as the regular ones. They're like 900, 1,000 milligrams of sodium. All I'm doing is just moving the meat around, kind of marinating it, letting all the seasonings gel together. And then I'm going to use some of this. This is called Kitchen Bouquet. It's a browning and seasoning sauce. I use that on beef meat. Just pouring some in here. I don't measure when I cook. I just do it by eye. Okay. I'm still just turning them over. To make sure you can see what I'm doing. Okay, so these are ready. I think I'm gonna hit them again. I wanted to put some garlic, some minced garlic in it. This is the minced garlic. Hit it with a fat tablespoon. I think I hit it with two. Two fat tablespoons of minced garlic. Just mixing those around. And I have some water like right behind me, some fresh dish water that I'm rinsing my hands off in as I go. Then I try to, if I can remember, keep one hand, you know, dry and one hand wet when you're doing this type of thing. So with my dry hand, I'm just going to hit it with a little more Pappy's. A little more onion powder. I love garlic, so I can't get too much garlic. A little more garlic powder. Okay, so we got that mixed up real good. Then I have this pot here. It's, I don't know if it's clay or ceramic. I think it's like clay or ceramic. A good girlfriend of mine gave this to me a number of years ago, and I love it. I use it for cooking this type of meat. It's perfect. So I'm just transferring the meat into here. Try to stand the oxtails up. I don't know why, but that's how I like them when I cook. When I cook them, stand them up. This is about 4 pounds of oxtails. This is like about $20. Oxtails are not cheap, but they're good when you have them. I have them every blue moon, so we don't have them often. Probably like every, 6 months or longer before we have them. Oh, this is almost perfect. Okay, that. Stick that little one in there, and there we go. And then I'm going to take this, the juices of the seasonings, and I'm just going to, probably should have been that way so you could see, but I'm not perfect. I'm just learning just to cook in the kitchen. Okay, so now that we got the meat ready, we need some vegetables on this meat. The vegetable that we're going to use right now is carrots. I don't know if I showed you this tray, but let me let you see. This is the tray of vegetables that we're using in our cooking today. Celery, carrots, tomatoes, bell pepper. I forgot the name of this pepper. I'm not sure, but it's a pepper. And onions. Okay. So these are going to go on top of the oxtails. Not too big, not too small. Just a nice rough chop. Throw those up there. I have four medium sized carrots. My celery, just a rough chop. All the vegetables have been washed prior to coming on camera. And with the celery, I'm even using the tops, the greens of it, the whole thing. More flavor. Okay, and then now I'm using some white onion. Doing some limes to make it easier cut. Something I picked up from the cooking shows. Just rough chopping them. And bam, you're done. Just break them up. Throw them up top. Okay. There we go there. I'm going to use this pepper that I picked up from the this is a poblano pepper. It may be, but I'm not like 100% sure as to the type of pepper. And there, so you can see, just got the meat covered. I'll add one more thing to it. This is a seasoning called Perfect Pinch. It's a salt-free, just herbs, and I'm going to sprinkle those herbs over top of the vegetables. And all that goodness is just going to go down and get into the meat and make the meat more flavorful. Okay, then I'm going to top. It's like a nice, heavy ceramic top. Put that on there, and I'm going to put these in the oven on 350 for probably approximately 2 hours. Okay, let's see. The meat has been cooking for about an hour and a half, hour 45, minutes. Still needs more time. I didn't put any water in it. It's just basically cooking in its own juices and the vegetables. But I might just put like just a tiny bit of water in it. Okay, we're just about there, but I'm going to put a little more water in these things and let them just cook a little more. They're tender. I touched them with the fork, but I want like a little juice, a little self-made gravy. Kind of cook up. They were really just cooking in their own juices, but I added some water. I want them to be super duper tender, where the meat just falls off the bone. It's tender now, but I want them a little more tender. A little more water. Top back one. Okay, the oxtails are ready now. They're nice and tender. Very tender. As you can see. Tender. Falling right off the bone. Get a fresh fork. Yep, they are ready. They're ready to eat now. Nice and tender. See that meat just come right off of there? They're tender. The only thing I put in them was water. Oxtails are greasy because they have like a lot of fat. So if I was to put this in the refrigerator right now and don't not eat it until tomorrow or whatever, you would see a lot of fat like around this part, because I see excess grease in there. So you can either pour it off if you want to, but me, I'm not gonna pour it off. I'm not gonna eat it, but I'm not gonna pour it off. I'm just gonna let the meat sit in it. And then like tomorrow after I put it in the refrigerator, I mean tonight after I put it in the refrigerator, and I take it out and it's like the fat is like white throughout there, I always like pick it off. But anyway, that's that. So next thing we're going to do is make a plate and let's see how our plate looks.